Hi everyone, today I'd like to show you a suitable way to fix your Canon Prima Super 155. So this I found is a common problem which consists in a blinking H showing on the display. If we turn the camera on, most often when we actually load the camera with a roll of film, instead of a number we find a blinking H, meaning there's an internal error, but every manual does not explain how to fix this. And looking online, I couldn't find an actual way to solve the whole problem. What I could find though was a video from YouTube channel Rafal Ra, I'll leave the link, which explains a way to partially fix this problem. I already fixed it and I'm going to show you how I did it. Partial because, well, let's call it a compromise. It does not fix the problem per se, but it finds a way to bypass it. By letting the camera think something that's not true, and that way we can overcome the problem. But we have to make a compromise, which is going to be, for example, not relying anymore on the counter. So this number will always stay at zero and the film will not load automatically. We're going to manually load it by pressing the shutter about 4 times, I think is the ideal number, but I'd like to mention that I did not try this yet on a full roll film. I did not develop a film after fixing my camera, so I cannot assure that this is going to 100% work and that this is going to give you good photos. I think it will, but I'm just not certain yet. I'm going to try soon. I will develop this role, and I will let you know. So the first thing to do is open this up. Let's do it. You'll have to remove the screws on the silver part, not on the black part. So this one, the one below, and the two on the other side. Now I actually suggest, before opening it up completely, before even removing the screws, I forgot, I suggest to remove the battery so that we won't have any problems. And the only thing left is to open this by hand, and you will probably need the help of one of these, so you can insert it and use it as a lever. Especially here above. Okay. Very gentle. Now this piece just fell off. Shit. Okay, so the piece that fell off was this one. If it falls off on you too, you just put it back on top. It's in the place of the shutter. It moves around, so try not to lose it. And so what's the procedure? I think it's very simple. I don't know anything about these cameras and I could make it, so I think you can too. So I'm gonna zoom in real quick. And what I did, as shown in the video of Rafal Ra, was this little tweak right here. I connected these two solders by soldering this bridge on top of them. I don't know if this applies for similar models to the Prima Super 155. I hope it does, but I cannot guarantee that. So there's three pins around here, and 1, 2, and 3, and it's important that this one stays disconnected. You just have to connect these two through this bridge, okay? I did a bit of soldering with the soldering iron. I used tin, so it doesn't have to be that complicated. Before soldering, I actually stuck the thing, the bridge, in place with some hot glue, so that it would stay there while I was soldering the two contacts. It's really just that. So this is the place where the camera detects that the door is closed, and if you short circuit it, the camera will think this is always open, and that actually fixed it for me, and I think it will fix it for many other people, since the problem should be the same for everybody. And yeah, I will show you how to load the film and you should be done. So once you connected the two things, once you bypassed the sensor of the door, you just close it back up. A quick pause. Now I think you remember the piece that fell off the camera while I was opening it. There were a piece that went under the shutter. Well, it turns out that putting it back in was a real struggle. So I want you to know, in case you find yourself in my exact situation, that to put it back in, you have to know that the piece is made by three smaller pieces. The first one that you have to put back in is the little disc. One side of it is silver and the other is lighter, like colored white. You have to put the lighter face facing downwards and the silver face facing upwards. Then you have to put the little rubber square, and then on top of that the metal silver part. I actually had to glue it down because it didn't want to stay in place. You figure it out yourself. You may use a little like hot glue, but not too much. Okay, so after desperate attempts to repair the shutter button, which I successfully did. All right, you can close the camera up using the same screws. However, I think that one is shorter than the other four. Yeah, it's this one, so I think I'll try to show it to you. Now, as you can probably see, I hope so, the one on the left is slightly shorter than the one on the right, and the four that are equally the same are the longer ones, and the shorter one is the one that goes below, where? Here. All right? So we take the short one and we put it under the camera. And then the other four are all the same. Now we have our camera up and running. Takes photo without film in, and to load up the film now it'll be kind of different because the camera won't do it by itself anymore. So when you put the film in, even if it didn't shoot, the camera would load it up for you, so it was still ready for use. Now when you put your film in. And load it. Nothing will happen. And I don't think it's a problem, because on all the other manual cameras out there, you have to load the film manually by yourself. So I think the optimal number of photos to take before the first usable piece of film is 4, I think. I'm not 100% sure again, I'm just estimating, and it may be 5, I doubt it's 3 times, it may be 5, it's one photo, you, if I'm wrong you'll miss one photo only, so it's not that bad. So let's do it together. Yeah, and you just shoot, and the film loaded, so it went to the next one, but the counter stayed on 0, because again, now the camera think that the door is open, so it's of no use to keep count of how many photos you've taken for the camera. For us it is, so you can write it down on paper, on your phone, somewhere to keep it on you, but yeah, so that was 1. This was 2. I heard some clicks inside. It was probably the film still clinging onto the roll. Then again, it may be 1 photo more, 1 photo less. I very doubt it's 1 photo less, so I don't think it's 3 instead of 4 clicks. It may be 5, even 6. I doubt it's 6, it may be 4 or 5 again. But yeah, so okay, so that should be it. As you can see, as you have seen, my camera did not show any problems with the film inside of it, while before this operation it did. It never let me take a single photo. It would always show the blinking H. Now it's gone. Again, you don't have the commodities anymore of the automatic loading and the counting of the number. I will show you some proof that the camera still reads the ISO code on the roll of film, because I did these tries that you're gonna see on screen, and as you can see, when I shoot without the film, the shutter stays open longer than when I put the film in. That's probably because of the default settings that the camera uses when no film is loaded, versus the settings that the camera uses when it detects my roll of film, which is ISO 200. As you can see, the zoom checks out, it doesn't give any problems, and once you're finished, you finished the film, you just turn the camera off and you press the rewind button. It just works as normal. As you can hear, the rewind is rewinding, and you should be done. Open, take out your film, and you're done. So it should probably still give you good photos. It should probably, again probably, still work and give you nice photos. I think the light will be balanced, but again, I'm not 100% sure. We'll have to find out for ourselves. I will hopefully post updates when I'll have my first film developed, and yeah, I hope I was of help. Good luck.